Blessed morning, my fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord. So for today, we will be talking about Zechariah 9 verse 9. So in Zechariah 9 verse 9, it says, "Rejoice greatly, daughter Zion. Shout, daughter Jerusalem. See, your king comes to you, righteous and victorious, lowly and riding on the donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey." So before we begin, let me ask you a simple question. What comes into your mind every time you hear the word king? Maybe you are thinking that there is someone who is wearing an expensive cloth. There is someone who is wearing a crown. There is someone who is being served at the palace. But here in this passage, Jesus showed us how different he is from all the other kings of this world. So we open here about the king, that he must be served in the palace, that he must have a many people, or he must be wearing expensive clothes before he can be called a king. But Jesus is a different king. He comes to us with humility and being lowly at heart. So if you still remember the story of triumphal entry in Matthew 21 verse 5, you can see how Jesus ride on a donkey, how Jesus rode on a donkey, and the people were shouting, "Hosanna, Hosanna," which means save us. And these people were the same people who shouted, "Crucify him, crucify him." So Jesus totally showed us how to be humble. Now, he comes to us with humility. He comes to us with peace, not with pride. Although he is Lord, he never exalts himself. Although he is the master, he is the creator of all things, he comes to us. He is the one who initiates to come to us. And siya yung king na nagpaprotect sa atin. Siya yung king na hindi inisip na maging mas mataas kaysa sa iba. He loves us. He showed us His grace or His humility by dying on the cross for our sins, so that we could live, so that we could escape the terrible death na naghihintay sa atin because of our sins. He is going to judge us. So in Zechariah 9 and in the previous verses, we can see there how Jesus, or how this humble king judged those nations who did a wicked thing or evil thing in his eyes. Knowing na ganun yung mangyayari in the future, how prepared are you? How rejoiceful are you? So it says here, he is coming. He comes to us righteous and victorious, without sin, blameless. He is the Lamb who was slain for us. And he is victorious. He have already won the world. So, as a believer, knowing that Jesus will be coming again, how excited or joyful are you? Do you rejoice? Or do you pray to God that gusto mo na siyang bumalik, gusto mo na siyang makita, gusto mo na siyang mayakap? Because the same Lord who saved you from your sin is the same God who will judge you when things are already fine with the Lord's timeline.